Hey guys, Armfro here. Got another part, maybe the last part, of Digimon Battle Card Game. We're here against Mega Kabuterimon in the Wiseman's Tower, which is the last arena in this whole game. I'm going to actually use my red deck. And here we go. This is going to be the last couple of battles in this series. And then we're going to move on to another LP finally. It's kind of, honestly, kind of dragged on for a little bit there. And 1, 2, 3, 4. Nice. I have to discard my whole hand. Lovely. There we go. That's better. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go for... You know what? I'm going to go for Diatomon. Discard Candlemon. Digivolve into Flareismon. Go for that Flare Buster. Blaze Buster, whatever. And I knew he was going to do that. Okay, sorry. Anyways, I'm going to go for this random card to hopefully get something to boost my circle attack. And that doubles my circle attack. That's awesome. So I get to attack first. I get to kill the little Tentomon easily with one blow. And there's one win for Flareismon right off the bat. Unluckily for me, I use an ultimate card, but it is one of the ultimate cards that's really hard to digivolve to. You need 50 DP to digivolve in that thing. That's extremely hard to get. So, Flareismon wins round one for me. Your move, Mega Kabuterimon. So, 1, 2, 3. Okay, he doesn't even get a champion card. I'm just gonna go for Blaze Buster again. I'm going to search for a random card. Okay, I knew he was going to do that. I wasn't even planning on using X anyways. That doesn't do anything for me. Awesome. So he pretty much gets damage on me, and I get a huge amount of chunk off him. He's going to bring him down in the tens, and it becomes my turn next turn. So it's a win-win situation for me. Use Electric Thread. Grass types don't really have that much power behind their attacks. So, I mean, this goes 350. Pretty good chunk for a rookie card. And Blaze Buster does 550. He has max HP of 680, so it's going to bring him down just above 100. So, hopefully it's my turn and I get something good. That's not good. God dang it. So, I'm just going to discard you. No, and I'm just going to use Blaze Buster again. There's nothing really more I can do here. Yep, 550, going to kill the Kunamon. But unluckily for me, there's nothing really more I could do after when it becomes his turn. Unless he gets a really weak rookie card, like the Kunamon again, I pretty much lose my Flareismon. And which really sucks, because I do have a speed digivolution, so if I drew my Metal Greymon, I could digivolve to him next turn, but I really highly doubt my Flareismon's going to live that long. So, here we go. 1, 2, 3. Yep. What'd I tell ya? Quagamon, the son of a bitch. So, I'm going to go for Blaze Buster. There's really no point for me doing any support. I'm just going to go for random, just in case I get, like, Bergermon or something. Biomon. That's not an eh. I guess. So, Quagmon is going to completely rape my Flareismon, but I do have a combo. My Flamedramon, my IVmon in my hand, I could armor Digivolve to Flamedramon. And with Agumon's attack... or support card, increases my attack by 300, I can do 960 damage to this Quagamon. He only has 900 HP. But if he draws a card, like a good support card, that like rearranges my circle attack, or even makes him go first, I'm fucked. So I'm just going to go for Fire Rocket. Oh, he didn't. That actually doubles his attack because HP is higher, but it doesn't matter because I get to attack, and he's fucked. So I'm going to do 960 damage. It's going to kill the Quagamon. And I beat Mega Kabuterimon with my Delicious Flame Jamon. Why did you just call my Digimon Delicious? What the hell? So I'm going to use Flare Blitz. I mean, Fire Rocket. Because Digimon, Pokemon, they're alike, right? So. Whoosh. Wah. Oh, and in the comments below, this is going to be my final part of Digimon Battle Card Game. Would you like me to do a playlist for this thing? I know some people just like watching the whole thing. I don't even know why you would watch the whole thing, because some parts are even like 30 minutes long. But you know what? If you want me to do it, I would gladly put it in the playlist. All 34 parts, I think, of Digimon Battle Card Game. So, I beat Mega Kabuterimon. Yeah, I beat Izzy, no one cares. So, next is Zudomon. It's Zudomon. Mwahaha. So, him, it's pretty obvious. I'm going to use my grass deck. Because he uses a blue and dark deck. I have a card for both cards in this grass deck. So, he uses Gomamon. Which could be dangerous. 1, 2, 3, 4. You know what? I'm feeling lucky. Patamon, Armor Digivolve. Take out Mori Shaman. Ooh, whoops, I went for X. Shit, dog. Ooh, what'd you do? This is... Both attacks are different, own attack is doubled. No, I want random cards for randomness. First attack. Yes, he used X! And my attack gets boosted! Oh, yes, that's good! I mean, I could have killed him next turn. Or I could have killed him this turn, actually. But now, because I use 500, I get 520 damage off on this guy. If he doesn't Digivolve next turn, I pretty much get to kill this Gomamon off, because my X attack does 220 and it makes me go first. So, he does 200 damage to my poor little Pegasusmon, because I did the wrong frickin' move. Because I try to spam X as fast as possible. Electamon saved my booty. So, he'll probably Digivolve into Ikakumon. Yep, hello Ikakumon, how you doing, buddy? I'm gonna go for Star Shower, Circle Attack. If he uses that thing, I'm gonna laugh. He did! Oh my gosh, he did that. Oh no, he didn't. The sad thing is, I was tempted to go for X, too. Mostly brings his attack to down to 10, but triples his attack power. It kills my Pegasusmon. It does kill my Pegasusmon, but he has, he has 10 HP. He pretty much kills my Pegasusmon. But... I mean, Pegasusmon didn't really do anything. It's because I screwed up. I'm sorry, Pegasusmon. I'm terribly sorry. Ugh. I'm sorry, my buddy. Could have won with you. So, here we go. Armor Digivolve. Now my turn. 1, 2. That does not do shit to me. You know what? Palamon. I like Angelmon, so I'm going to keep her. And I'm going to just use Root Breaker. I'm going to heal the 10 HP off me that he has. And I'm going to use Mega Defense Disc. Decreases the circle attack, increases my HP, mostly just to gain as much HP off this turn as possible. I'm going to gain the 10 HP that I'm going to be doing to him into my health. And it's just for next turn, just in case. I mean, some games have been won on 10 HP. From this guy in this game, so I get the 10 HP that he dies from, and I get to kill his Ikakumon, which usually has at least one fuckload of HP. So I'm actually really happy for that. So I have 610 after this turn, which is pretty good, and I get the attack disc. Okay, Charmamon. What's this? Both attacks are different, so. It's going to double. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to use Poison Ivy, my circle attack, because if he uses that rod, the most he could do is 700 damage, but our attacks have to be Fart. Both attacks are different. Shit. Misread it. I am screwing up, aren't I? Oh! That decreases my attack to zero, I think? Oh, that just cuts my HP in half. Which I'm probably gonna digivolve next turn, so it does not matter at all if my HP is cut in half. So, it actually rounds down too, which really sucks. But, Poison Ivy, which 670 damage is gonna easily kill the Charmamont, so that's round two to me. Now I'm ahead. Nyeh, nyeh. Go, Palmon. So now I hopefully will digivolve into champion. I really hope I do. I need to draw a champion card. Yes, Leomon, I like it. And I get a lot of HP. And he gets Snogaboriumon. So discard 7 on lines. Own attack becomes the same as HP. That's still not going to help. That does not... Actually, none really works. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use Beast King's Fist and use my Circle Hitter, which if he did use Circle, I go first and my attack gets increased by 500 points. Awesome. It's still not going to kill me. And I get to kill you next turn. So, Leomon, thank you for your Beast HP. So, Freeze Gobu Breath is going to do 770 damage. I have 890, so I'm going to live that with a minuscule HP. Go for Beast King's Fist, which is really good because now I can take him out next turn. One, two. Yes, I get to Speed Digivolve! Speed Digivolve and Angewomon! Celestial Arrow to finish this little Snogaboriumon off. That does not matter at all, so I'm just going to use random card for randomness. Doubles his attack. Go Angewomon. Completely destroy this little guy. So that's going to be two down. I think two more to go. I do believe it's Metal Garurumon, then Wargreymon. And honestly, Wargreymon's pretty easy to beat. The only problem is actually Metal Garurumon is a lot harder than Wargreymon. Because Metal Garurumon has a defensive deck. And they're bitches. They're at least one bitch and a half. So, here we go. Zudomon! Yeah. Not gonna give up. Top of the day. Go ahead, Govna. There's Garurumon! I actually completely forgot about you. Yeah. Battle. Because this is pretty much the last three guys are Garurumon, Garurumon, blah, blah, blah. I cannot speak today. Garurumon, Metal Garurumon, and Wargreymon are the last three. So I'm going to go first with my blue deck, which pretty much counters red. That's why I completely forgot about this guy, because it's pretty much useless. So, Solarmon. I'm going to use... Well, it's going to be my turn next turn. So I'm just going to use Eternal Slapping, 320 damage. And defense disc. He attacks first. So that is nothing. He actually does some damage to me. That's surprising. So he's gonna do, I think, 350. But even after that, it's not gonna be much. Oh, he went Soul Shocker. What am I talking about? I decreased the circle down to zero. So it's gonna do 210. But I'm going to do 320 damage, which is going to be a two-hit KO, and I pretty much killed his Solarmon. But that's not what I'm trying to focus on now. What I am actually going to do is just going to try to digivolve into Ice Devimon. Takes 40. I can do that. So, Eternal Slapping again. Make him go first. Yep. Knew it. I'm going to go for Training Manual. Increases my HP by 10, my 100. And, oh, yep. Yep, I knew it. He's going to do 180. Mostly makes him crash. Brings him down to 10 HP, but makes him go boom, boom. So it does 180 damage to me, but brings him down to 10. But it doesn't really matter because I was going to kill him anyway. It was actually a lot less than how much what I thought he was going to do, which was 350. I'm actually really fine with this. And someone sent me a message. So, 320 damage, killed a Solarmon. Round 1 goes to Penguinmon. Yeah, dance, Penguinmon. Dance, my little Digimon! Okay. 1, 2, 3. Another Solarmon. Digivolve into Bergermon. What do you have? If own attack is not circle attack, recover own HP by 300. Special. What I'm going to do is I'm going to do X, which is Ice Prism. And I'm going to go for a Dolphinmon. Because he can't kill me. He can't kill me if he goes for triangle attack. Because it's going to do 310 damage. But he could kill me with a circle attack. That's why I countered the circle attack. So he went for circle. I do 500 damage with the ice prism. So it brings Bergermon down to a 210. Which is really good. So now I can actually digivolve an ice Devimon. So what I'm actually going to do is take Patamon out and digivolve an Ice Devimon. Just because this doubles my attack if he's a fire attack. And I want to do as much damage with the Sub-Zero Freeze as possible against his last guy. So, no support cards, please. It triples when it's attacking a fire type. And Bergermon's a fire type. His whole deck is a fire type. So, I pretty much kill his Bergermon very, very easily with the Ice Devimon. And next turn, pretty much, when it comes to his turn again, he loses. Because I don't think any card can take an X attack that's going to be doubled and then tripled. So it's going to be 360 tripled, around over 1,000 damage. Unless he can somehow decrease my attack to zero, I pretty much win. So here we go. 1, 2, 3. Beomon, he can't digivolve. So, Sub-Zero Freeze. This would be even enough to kill him. But I'm going to do Overkill and double my fire, since he's a fire type. I know he was going to do that. Increases HP by 500 points. Yep. First attack, he's going to attack first. 180, and then triple it again. I still kill him. Nice try, trying to live that off. But he's going to go for Pecker, Turbo Pecker, I think. Does 130 damage. Now he's going to bring me down under 1,000. And I get to kill him with my X attack, which is just so much freaking dead. Sub-Zero Freeze. Get the hell out of here. 1080 damage. That's going to be an easy kill. That was a pretty easy win from Garudamon. That's why Metal Greymon is... War Greymon. I keep on saying Metal Greymon. War Greymon is just so easy. Just because I have such a deck that counters fire-type decks. It's just so easy to counter fire. That's why I hardly even use my fire deck. But even though my red deck is probably one of my strongest, I don't use it all the time because blue completely counters it. Looks like I'm not much for competition. Go ahead. Yes, you prefer yourself before moving on. So, Metal Garurumon. Hello, it's me. Yeah, Metal Garurumon. Let's battle. So, last two battles, Metal Garurumon and War Greymon. Then this game will be over. Such a long LP that this has been. So I get to attack first and recover second, which could be good, could be bad. He has to discard his whole hand. Oh, that's awesome. Okay, Snow Gaboriumon. Can't evolve into Garurumon yet. 1, 2, 3, 4. Ugh, that's tough. You know what? I might have to do it. Armor Digivolve. No, Angel Woman. I'm sorry. So I'm gonna go for Fire Rocket. How do I know he would do that? Makes him attack first and increases his HP by 100 points. I'm gonna go for Attack Disc just to kill him off. So that's pretty much an automatic kill for me. Unless he could live, which he can't. And next turn I'll probably just go for X and do my medium recovery floppy. And Bolt Strike. 330 damage. I'm down to 320. Next turn I'll be up to 820, so it's all good. So Fire Rocket, Flare Blitz. Easily KO. So that's automatically a win for me. So Metagorurumon is already one down. Hopefully he doesn't get a rookie and another Digimon card. 1, 2, 3. Oh, yep, he got a lot. Gizmon, Digivolves to... Yep, Icemon. I'm going to use Express Claw, which is my X attack. And I'm going to go for my Medium Recovery Floppy, which cuts my attack by half, but increases my HP by 500 points. It doesn't really matter, because... Oh, God. Hopefully he went for Circle. Go for Circle. Please go for Circle. If he goes for Circle, I pretty much KO him. He got a really unlucky card if he did the, if he went for Circle attack. He went for Circle! Oh my gosh, that claw. It cuts his attack in half, but makes his attack, his HP. Which completely wrecks himself. And I get the HP bonus from the medium recovery floppy. Flamejamon might just wreck through this guy. I don't need anything. So. Yep. Gabumon? Gabumon! Armor Digivolve 2! I always love Gabumon's voice. So, I'm just gonna go for Triangle. I'm gonna go for the most ridiculous HP I possibly can, which is 1,000, almost 2,000 HP. Because I pretty much don't need support cards anymore from this guy. So, I just went for 370 damage. That twice is going to easily KO this Gabumon, because it's going to be my turn next turn, so I pretty much win against Metagorurumon. Oh, Lord. So Little Horn is going to do, I think, 200-something? 220. And I'm going to go for 370 damage. And... I mean, there's really nothing more you could do. I almost went for X. I almost spammed X. So I'm going to go for Triangle Attack. He's going to go for Random Card. And I'm going to go for Random Card too. What do you know? We're buddies. Random buddies. Increases his attack by double if he discards his whole hand. I got nothing. But luckily for me, I get to frickin' destroy him. Woohoo! So, Flamejamon completely wrecks his face off. Poor little Gabumon. Wow! And I beat him. Metagorurumon is already dead. Last guy in the series. War Greymon. Oh, I lost again. Test of Endurance. Yeah. Whoa, hello, what just happened? I do not know what just happened. There we go. Okay, sorry, guys. War Greymon. Look how far you've come. This arena was prepared especially for you. Yes, I've enjoyed myself. This is the final battle. That's the final countdown. Whoops. So I'm going to use my blue deck, obviously, against this red deck. I'm going to go first, which is even awesomer. Did I seriously just say awesomer? So, you know what? Sorry, Pangemon. 1, 2, 3, 4. Solarmon. Stun Bubble, 330 damage. I'm going to cut his power in half. Seedramon is not a good Digimon to Digivolve to. So I'm going to cut his attack in half. He went for Crash, so that's pretty much a KO for me automatically. So he's going to do 500 damage, and I bring himself down to 10, and I'm going to kill him again. So, why does everyone with Solarmon go for the Crash right off the bat? It's kind of stupid. Crash isn't even a good thing to do. The AI in this game is so retarded. I thought even, like, the last battle, you'd be like, oh, yeah, he's gonna be really good and really smart. No, he's a derp-a-derp. Automon wins round one. Frickin' A. So, my turn. 1, 2, 3. Nice. I don't even need this frickin' thing. Ice Devimon, all the way. Solarmon. Digivolve into Greymon. Yes, thank you, a good challenge. So what I'm going to do is I am going to go for Mega Defense Disc with my triple attack. That doubles his, increases his HP or attack by 200 points if he's a fire type, I think. And no, changes himself to a fire type. He actually went for counter, which does 200 damage to me. That's pretty good. And I pretty much, this is a good bet. This is a better match than I thought it was going to be. But I'm still going to do 560 damage to this guy. He's going to go for Firewall. 200 damage because it was a counterattack. With this guy, you never go for Circle. Unless you're fighting a non-fire type deck, which would be kind of retarded. I don't know why you would use this deck against non-fire type. So, now it's my turn again. 1, 2, 3. Oh my gosh. I'm going to use Sub-Zero Freeze again. I don't even need any of my support cards right here, so what I'm going to do is going to use Training Manual, which actually increases my HP by 100 points and draws until I have 4 cards in my hand. Increases his circle attack. Doesn't matter at all. He's going to be a dead Greymon. And the next turn is going to be the best thing ever. It's going to be the best thing to end this series on. I swear to God, it is. So I'm going to use Sub-Zero Freeze. 540 damage to him. Easily KOs him. Marr, dead Greymon. Ice Devimon. I mean, the final guy doesn't even have any speed cards, which is the best cards in the game, which kind of sucks. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. Agumon. Can't even Digivolve. Sub-Zero Freeze. And what I'm going to do is, for the last battle of the game, I'm going to use Ikakumon, which triples my attack because it's a fire type, before it gets tripled. So it's going to do around 1,800, I think. So that gets tripled to 540. That's get tripled to over 1,600 damage. So that's going to be the final, like, the finale of this series. Just Ice Devimon completely wrecking War Greymon. He doesn't even get one good move off against me. He doesn't even get a kill. So Sub-Zero Freeze completely wrecks his shit. And that's going to be pretty much it. That's going to be the game. Oh, wait. Whoa, what am I doing here? Hello, file and quick save. There we go. I was there the whole time, wasn't it? Eh, whatever, I don't care. That is going to be it. That is going to be... And all my cards rank up on the last battle. That is going to be it. That was a good game. It was a good series. I even did all the extras for you guys. really glad we met. You give me a chance to take myself to another level. Thank you. I hope we'll meet again. Let's both reach the top. The super green deck, super green pack, super blue pack, and the super red pack. So, that will be it for this series. Thank you guys for sticking with me so much on this series. Next series, look for it, Digimon World. So thanks for watching, guys. Rate, comment, subscribe. Thank you, guys, and stay classy.